I think corals are important because they're the foundation of an entire ecosystem that the human race relies on for many different aspects of their life, whether they live right next to the reef or miles away in the middle of the mountains in the Midwest. Everybody has some connection to coral reefs in some way. And I think it's very important for us to give back to them all the wonderful things they've given to us through the years and the decades they've been here. I think that what I'm doing and the team here at the Georgia Aquarium is doing is extremely important to help corals. I do a lot of this for my role here, of course, as a marine biologist, but I also want to make sure that my daughter and my grandchildren in the future can experience the beautiful reefs that we, you know, used to see and care for them just as much as I do. And I think that I'd rather try and fail than not try at all. My involvement with corals here is both on site at the main building, helping to build and maintain the coral reef habitat that you see behind me, as well as the quarantining of all the corals that come in and working with the team on that side of it. And then the propagation and the field work down in the Florida Keys, doing restoration work and conservation work down there. For probably about 10 years now, about 2008, we started working with the Coral Restoration Foundation down in Key Largo, specifically working with some endangered species of corals that really needed our help. And we were able to form a partnership with them because they just needed volunteers and help. So every year we kind of get a group together and we all meet down there for the annual spawning and get to share our expertise and learn together with that and kind of grow that partnership and be able to learn and do more research with those animals. A couple years ago, we had the pleasure of actually bringing some of the baby corals or the planula back on site here to be able to settle onto substrate and eventually grow. We've nicknamed him Baby Groot because of how he looked with his first couple polyps when he was a young one. It's great to show that animal and be able to put him under the microscope and show people who've never seen a small coral. They don't sometimes understand that it starts from just one tiny planula or one tiny polyp. That's all you need. So he's a great ambassador for the Georgia Aquarium and for our work here, and we hope to have more planula and babies in the future. My hope for the future is that we really make a difference, even just a little, to know we did our part. You know, when we look at public aquariums, our job and our mission is to educate the public. And the best way to educate the public is to try to establish a connection with the people and to the animals. And to be honest, it's a little bit easier when that animal has eyes that you can look into. Most people think that they're just colored rocks or that they're a plant, but they are living animals. They're a type of invertebrate. It basically gives refuge and homes to probably about 25% of all marine life. And with all of the threats that it's facing, it's hard for the animal to survive. They don't have the luxury of picking up and moving to another location. They, as soon as they settle in the rock work and on the reef, that's where they are at for the rest of their life. They're estimating if we don't do something with the reefs, a lot of species could potentially go extinct out there. And I hope that there's plenty of people out there who want to do what I do right now and can keep this going for generations to come.